get crazy, get wild. Let's party, get loud. If you wanna have fun and do something, if you wanna have fun and do something, get crazy, get wild. Let's party, get loud. If you wanna have fun and do something, if you wanna have fun and do something.
Hi, I'm Joseph Obeger.
And I'm Richard Gonzalez, and this is
CPTV.
And now for this segment, we're gonna have some senior updates with Wilbur.
Good morning, CPTV. I'm Will Morales from CPTV, and today I'm here with Prom Committee. And today we have
Miss Baskerville Norris,
Mr. Sherwood,
Haley Iglesias,
Rosie Bonilla.
And today I'll be asking them a few questions about the prom. Where's the prom going to be held?
Okay, so this year's prom is going to be at the Terrace and Biagio's in Paramus.
We're
still working on that, actually. We have a few more fundraisers. There's a chance where you can actually impact that.
About our fundraisers, and I'll follow up with the next question. What fundraisers do you have for this?
Currently, we are running snack bars at the varsity basketball games. So that's been going well so far. We have the senior versus faculty basketball game that's coming up in March. So I hope all the seniors out there watching this pay your dues so you can play.
Okay, one more big one, that's the popcorn fundraiser. The popcorn fundraiser has really been successful as far as getting us enough money to pay deposit on the venue. So it's important that everyone support this upcoming popcorn fundraiser, which we'll let you know when it's going to be.
Next question is there a theme for the prom?
There's a theme. We actually came up with it like right away, and I think we all like it.
Yeah. So the theme is the Enchanting Met Gala.
The question has been asked, what is the date of the prom, and the prom will be held on June 7th.
June 7th.
Yeah. Wednesday, June 7th, 2023.
To help out the fundraisers, make sure you buy your snacks and all that good stuff so you have a big prom. And that's it.
And for our next segment, we're going to do a report on Martin Luther King Jr. and his importance on our history.
Hello, and welcome back from our three-day weekend. We know we have been taught about MLK Jr. in school since kindergarten.
It occurs to us that some students have forgotten the importance of Martin Luther King Jr., so we want to give a little history lesson about his importance to our history and why we have the third Monday of January off. His leadership was crucial to the movement's success in ending the legal segregation of African Americans in the South and in other parts of America.
King rose to national prominence as head of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, which promoted nonviolent tactics, such as the massive march on Washington in 1963 to achieve civil rights.
On November 2, 1983, President Ronald Reagan signed the King Holiday Bill into law, designating the third Monday in January a federal holiday in observance of civil rights leader Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
How you doing today, Mr. Guerra?
Not well.
May we ask you a few questions about Martin Luther King Jr.? All right, so what's your name?
Mr. Guerra.
All right, Mr. Guerra, so how do you think the importance of Martin Luther King affected America?
I think Dr. King's legacy is really one of a tireless commitment to justice, not only for African Americans during the Civil Rights Movement, but beyond. One of my favorite speeches of his is the Beyond Vietnam speech that he made towards the end of his life before his assassination in 1968. And it shows that even in the years following the civil rights struggle, he was really committed to improving the country as a whole in a lot of different areas.
All right, thank you.
My pleasure.
For his last segment, we will be doing a piece on Kanye West and the importance of mental health.
Kanye West.
Also known as Ye, is one of the most critically acclaimed and controversial American rappers, producers, and fashion designers of the 21st century.
Yo, Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'm gonna let you finish. But Beyonce had one of the best videos of all time. One of the best best videos of all time. As you probably could have guessed by this moment, I have decided in 2020 to run for president.
When you hear about slavery for 400 years, for 400 years, that sounds like a choice. Like, you was there for 400 years and it's all of y'all?
Hitler, I see good things about Hitler also. You can't say out loud that this person ever did anything good, and I'm done with that. I'm done with the classifications. Every human being has something of value that they brought to the table, especially Hitler.
Free speech was created to encourage people in expressing their opinions without the fear of receiving unjust consequences. The First Amendment states Congress shall make no law abridging the freedom of speech or of the press or the right of the people peacefully to assemble.
But it has also created an opportunity for those who want to spread misinformation without experiencing consequences.
There are no limits to free speech. It's all context, right? Everyone has thoughts and ideas, and then people try to manipulate your thoughts and ideas. In order for humanity to move forward, we have to be free to think and then to actualize.
While you are afforded the ability to say 99.9% of whatever you want, wherever and whenever, it's that 0.1% of things that people often misunderstand and think they are protected against when they're not.
There are limits to free speech. U.S. Court Speech Rights states the categories of speech that are not protected from government restrictions are incitement, defamation, compelling interest, obscenity, commercial speech, and fighting words.
How do you feel about Kanye?
I think that Kanye's views are problematic.
I like the old Kanye West, but him right now...
Shouldn't be given a platform to voice these delusional thoughts.
That a lot of people are using this as an opportunity to be like very openly racist to him.
I like his music a lot. Him as a person is kind of like,
he's a bad person.
Horrible person.
Mental health is a real thing, you know. Like, he's moving a bit too mad.
I'm not doing that.
And I think that the level of accountability he's being held to is not the level of accountability that people take towards white people that are like equal establishment, equal wealth, equal influence.
He needs meds, not cameras.
Free speech isn't something you can take advantage of. The limits are real.
For the next 5 episodes, we are going to explore the topics of hate speech, social media, shock value, consumerism, and mental health. All these tie into who Kanye is and what he has become.
Thank you for watching this episode of CPTV. See you next time.
Get crazy, get wild, let's party, get loud. If you wanna have fun and do something.